Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. Respected viewers, assalamu alaikum. Welcome to Heyat Online. Inshallah, you are incorporating us in your du'as because the du'as in the month of Ramadan are accepted. How can we improve ourselves during this month? We have a limited time, about 30 days that we have, and sooner or later, they're going to say that Eid has come and this holy month is not here anymore. So we want to self-improve as much as possible. In the last sessions, we talked about few opportunities that we have in the month of Ramadan. What is another opportunity? What else can we focus on in this month? One of the problems that last session we talked about was that mankind is weak when it comes to their willpower. And there are few people in this world that really focus on themselves and they have the strength to attain their dreams. They're committed to their dreams and they will sacrifice for their dreams and they will attain it. So we talked about the willpower, strengthening our willpower being very important, crucial for our success. And one of the tricks that we can learn and one of the tips that I can give you and I give myself, of course, is that we can contain this dangerous nafs, these lower desires, by having an appropriate schedule for ourselves. When you have a schedule, when you manage your time, you're not going to allow others to come to take your time away from you without any reason. There are some people that are always yes people. I might be one of them myself. When someone asks me for something, it's hard for me to say no. Sometimes the things they ask for you are not that important. And if you already have a schedule, you won't allow that person to come into your life that is might possibly have a negative effect in your life. Yes, helping people in the positive way is the best of actions, no doubt about it. But we have to prioritize. And that's what you do when already you sit down today and you write your plans, or at least you think about your plans for tomorrow. You're going to be successful. You're not going to allow that nafs to take you to wherever it wants to, the lower desires. So time management is learned in the month of Ramadan. Look how Allah beautifully in this month has given us instructions. I'm sure if you even tried to, my own opinion is this, if we tried to write and design these acts of worship, humans couldn't. I think that these commands of God themselves are miracles for us. Salat itself is a miracle. It's so beautiful, the way we pray in congregation, the direction that we pray. And also fasting is beautiful for us. In so many places, we benefit from fasting. One of those areas is time management, right? That suhoor time you have, that time to eat, that time to pray is very exact. That iftar time that you have is very exact. And each day, sometimes it changes. Each day it changes by a minute. So Allah is teaching us to observe even every minute of our lives, have a plan for us, because each minute you will be gaining and you will be developing your eternity. So we learn, for example, from different hadith we have to manage our time. It talks about Imam Ali alayhi salam, which this is also the month of Imam Ali, that he talks about during his deathbed, you could say, this wasiyyat that he has in Nahjul Balagha letter 45, that he tells Imam Hassan alayhi salam, he instructs Imam Hussein, Usikuma wa jami'u wuldi wa ahli wa man balaghahu kitabi. And whoever my letter reaches, my children, and whoever my letter reaches, that is us, our letter, his letter, alhamdulillah, has reached us, attributed to Amir al-Mu'mineen. I advise you two things. Amir al-Mu'mineen, the champion of spirituality, the champion of the worship of God, says two things. Wa nadhm, I say, وَمَنْ بَلَغَهُ كِتَابِي بِتَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَالنَّذْمِ أَمْرِكُمْ. Two things, not sinning, guarding yourself against sin, and the second, organizing your affairs, being organized people, coming to meetings on time, scheduling everything for yourself in an appropriate manner so that you can make the most of that precious time that you have. And therefore, you will not allow the nafs to come in to be able to steer you away from your dreams and your goals. So brothers and sisters, keep us in your dua And inshallah, we learn from the month of Ramadan how to manage our time. Take care and see you next time. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.